Hello everyone, I am Mr. Smith, and I want to welcome you to the Fall 2019 Semester English 21-22 class, which is British Literature 2. So every Monday morning when you wake up, you can expect one of these videos to be here. If not, I'll give you a note explaining that the video may be a little late, but for the most part, every week we'll have this video so I can explain to you what's going on in the upcoming week. So really, since this is the first week, you don't need your textbook yet, but do get that textbook by next week if you can, because we really need to hit the ground running here. And the reading assignment for next week will actually have a portion of the preface to Lyrical Ballads. And you don't want to read the whole preface when you're only going to have to concentrate on a few pages. So get those textbooks as soon as you can. This week, look at the syllabus. And there are a few key points I want to mention. First of all, notice that the textbook is in there. Also notice on here the attendance policy, the makeup work policy, plagiarism policy. I do have like zero tolerance for plagiarism. So if you plagiarize in this class, you will fail it. So don't copy and paste anything. Everything you turn in should be your own work. And so be aware of that. And let's see what else we've got here. We've got the... you know, be respectful of me and be respectful of your fellow classmates. There's not a lot of interaction between classmates in this class, but, you know, be respectful of everybody. And finally, the last thing on the syllabus before we get to the schedule, and of course the schedule is both separate in the syllabus and schedule folder, and is attached to the end of the syllabus. So either way, you're going to be able to get it. Take a look at the last thing I say before the schedule, which is the extra credit opportunities. In order to pass this class, you really need to do the work. If you decide to wait until the end of the semester and you've not done a thing and you send me a desperate email saying, oh, please, can I have extra credit opportunities? The answer will be no. You won't be able to have extra credit opportunities. So the way to pass this class is to stay caught up and do the work. It is not to wait until week 14 or 15 and all of a sudden give me a desperation email saying, oh, I have to pass this class to graduate. Well, the time to worry about your grade is now in August. The time to worry about your grade is not in December. So start doing the work that's necessary to pass now. So what are we doing this week? Kind of a history lesson, really. And you may be thinking, well, this is supposed to be a British literature class, not a history class. Why, Mr. Smith, are you making us do a history lesson? But there's a reason for it. And the reason is that once we start getting into the first readings from Wordsworth, from Coleridge, from Blake, from Wollstonecraft, from other authors, they will refer back to things that occurred earlier in British history, things such as the Declaration of Right or the Magna Carta. And this will continue on throughout the entire semester. So in order to understand what you're reading in the, say, writings of an 18th century or a 19th century author, you need to understand what happened in, say, the 13th century. So this week, and you don't really need the textbook for this week's lesson because there are no real readings, but there is a quiz. There's a pre-1800 quiz. So, because our class picks up around 1790, 1795, when Coleridge and Wordsworth put out their Lyrical Ballads. So, use Google, use whatever other sources you have. There won't be any danger of plagiarism because, you know, it's a multiple choice test. Or perhaps if it's not a multiple choice test, it's a short answer test. But there will be a short test to see what you have learned. There's also a PowerPoint slideshow. There will be PowerPoint slideshows every week to help supplement the readings. So use those slideshows to your advantage. There will be quizzes every week, and starting next week, there'll be a writing assignment every week. I don't have a research project at the end of the semester, which is probably good news for most of you because you're going to be overwhelmed with projects from other classes. But you will have to write four paragraphs a week for me, which is about a page or two. And that's because we're not in a classroom setting, so I have to know that you've read and understand and thought deeply about the actual questions and about the readings. And all of these questions will require some critical thinking. So they won't be simple like what happens on page 5. They'll be thinking about something and then writing about your observations. So that's it. So go through the syllabus, go through the schedule, understand the syllabus, and then take that little history quiz and you'll be ready to hit the ground running. And then next week, we'll start using the textbooks. So with that in mind, I wish you all well. Let's all have a great semester together. And if you have any questions, you can reach me through the email. I usually check that every day. So send me an email if you have any questions. Thank you.